Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on this live Friday worldwide edition of the Alex Jones Show, or what I call InfoWars Live. We're going to be here live for the next 3 hours, and we have joining us coming up Skull and Bones whistleblower, and of course, former head of policy at the Department of Education, Charlotte Iserbyt. To break down Common Core and how that ties into the deliberate dumbing down of this country and the world. And she is going to be joining us coming up today in the second hour, for part of the second hour. And then I'm going to get Reverend Childress on, blackgenocide.org, who's an author and filmmaker and researcher, dealing with the extermination of black people in this country, targeted via abortion and other systems. And now the Democratic Party, on record, this has been their mission since about 1900, when the Klan couldn't basically annihilate black people by openly trying to kill them. They then just posed as their friends. And that's actually on record. So you should know that. And with the culture they've sold through MTV and the rest of it, they've done an incredibly good job in damaging the culture across the board, not just so-called urban or black culture, weaponized culture. So if they can't kill you in the womb, they're going to get you with the chemicals, the biologicals, the thug gangster culture, so they can put you in a prison. So we're going to be talking to Reverend Clenard Childress coming up in the third hour as well. And we will open the phones up during both those guests today. My uncle did pass today at about 3:30 a.m. And the reason I mention it is a lot of you prayed for him, and I appreciate he was a great guy, one of the people that was instrumental in helping wake me up to how the world really worked. 68 years old, a Vietnam helicopter pilot veteran, just a great patriot and one of the best men I've ever known. When you say he's a good guy, he's a sweet person, he's a smart person, you literally, that's the only thing that comes to mind when you talk about my uncle, William Forrest Hammond. So he's gone now. And you got Barbara Bush in a hospital fighting basically the same thing. It is a bacterial pneumonia that grows in the space made by the mutated flu virus, according to Dr. Sherry Tenpenny, medical doctor who has clinics in the U.S. and other countries. And it was incredible because I hadn't talked to her until she was on air yesterday, and she was saying the same names the doctors in Texas were saying to me of the bacteria and of what they thought had happened. So this is directly correlated and linked to vaccines causing viral mutations. And then the antibiotics causing mutations and drug-resistant bacteria. And most people I know that have died haven't even died in the last 20 years, friends and family, in car wrecks. That used to be the number one cause of death. And then heart attacks and cancer. Everybody's dying from hospital infections. And he was sick when he finally went to the hospital with a mutation that developed basically out of the medical system. All the evidence points towards it. But the doctors said point blank in there. They said if he can survive any hospital pathogens, you know, he may live. Because he was there about a week and a half ago. But my uncle, after he was taken off the sedation and the ventilator and all the rest of it, passed on his own in about a day. So he's in a better place. He's moved on to the next level. And believe me, many of us have seen it. There is the next level. And I just feel sorry for all those out there who, well, as the major studies show, do not have the brain tissue density and neuron density to pick up on the other world. The silence. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us on this live third day of January 2014. We're going to be here, Lord willing, for the next 3 hours. Just going to finish up talking about my uncle, and then I'm going to get into all of the incredibly important geopolitical, economic, Obamacare news, police state news. You name it, it is all extremely important. The record cold hitting much of the world right now. And, of course, the UN and other organizations respond by claiming the Earth just saw record heat, which actually isn't even true, but they don't care. The sun, folks, is the reason the ice caps on the Martian landscape were melting until about 5 years ago. And then the sun began to cool dramatically and is now in a record low level of emissions of all types, not just visible light that heats the Earth. And so that's why we're plunging into cold. I don't need to be a rocket scientist to know the sun is the main driver of climate on the planet, but I have had top climatologists, top physicists, top astrophysicists, top meteorologists and others on the broadcast many, many times from Russia, from England, from the United States to break that down. And they have the ice core samples that they can then reflect with the sun cycles that they have registered in the last 200 years, and they know what's going on with the sun. On Monday, the sun flipped polarity. They believe, obviously, it's happened before. This is the first time it was observed by radio telescopes. And polarity didn't just flip. The sun flipped. The sun flipped. And it sent a whole bunch of different types of particles up the Earth that come into the atmosphere, and then water gathers around them as they come into the atmosphere, the nuclei, and then that forms haze, then clouds, then rain. That's why when they have big solar flares, real astrophysicists, folks that actually done the research have known for 100-plus years that when you have a bunch of solar flares and sunspots, that they know, even if there's clear blue skies, look for haze to form, then thunderheads, then rain, because that's the main driver also of what goes on in our atmosphere is the sun. But Minnesota, worst deep freeze in 20 years. That's saying a lot where it routinely gets 40 below. Wind chills may hit 50 below. Blast up to 30 inches of snow in New England. Totals. Exposed skin freezes in 15 minutes. Worker crushed to death by 100-foot salt pile. Fighting the snow. Killer chiller map. DrudgeReport.com. Has that. We can punch it up and click it. New York City mayor, too cold for school. Sun played role in cancellation. America spent $7.45 billion fighting global warming in other countries. MSNBC host complains of snow trolling. North Arctic rescue ship stuck in ice. Or now, Antarctic rescue ship is stuck in ice. So it's continuing. A very, very serious situation, obviously, with temperatures below zero all over areas of North America into the north of the United States. So that's just some of the news on that front. So they've responded by coming out and saying that it's record high temperatures, and I'm going to be getting into that article. Also, the full horror that is Obamacare is now setting in for the minions of it. And we have a lot of these articles up on prisonplanet.com and infowars.com right now. Daily Mail. They had no idea if my insurance was active or not. Obamacare confusion reigns as frustrated patients walk out of hospitals without treatment. See, you thought you went and signed up for Obamacare. I've been saying this for 2 months. You didn't sign up for it. Okay? The only way you, quote, sign up for it is when the insurance company increases your current plan or kicks you off and makes you buy more. Here's another one. Obamacare's use expected to spike beginning next week. And, of course, the prices are set to go up, the Hill reports. Data goldmine. Walgreens, Walmart offer free prescriptions to Obamacare customers for their data. Because when you enroll in Obamacare, you waive all your rights to privacy, and that's extremely valuable. but only the first round to the insurance companies and others. Doctor's office, CBS News reports, spends 2 hours on hold with health insurer for patient surgery authorization. That's right. If you're an illegal alien, you immediately go to the head of the line. But if you have insurance now, this happened to my friend who took his daughter with a sinus infection to the hospital. I would just go to a clinic, less killer bugs, and it was, he shot video of it, just nothing but illegal aliens, all being put to the front of the line. He had insurance, had to wait 3 hours. It was double the cost it had been previously. One of our crew members went to his regular medical doctor, his general practitioner yesterday, more than double the price. Couldn't see his doctor, saw a assistant, what he's never done, and basically didn't get any care. So hope you enjoy that. Continuing, Oregon mother, I can't afford Obamacare for myself or my one-year-old son. She could afford it before her insurance, but now she can't. Well, that's part of the good deal. I mean, the wolf of the White House, Obama and the globalists make the wolf of Wall Street, and I did see the movie last night. It was very well done, but pornographic to the max. The most pornographic film in a movie theater I've ever seen. And I went to analyze it, and I saw the audience laughing profusely when he was conning and ripping people off and getting off on it. And I realized America loves get-rich schemes. They love to be conned. When people get conned by lottery tickets or penny stocks, they never stop. They only get more into it. And you know, just it's all part of this imaginary. Everybody's going to be a rock star. Everybody's going to be a movie star. Everybody's going to be a sports star. Everybody's going to be, but nobody's going to be a good father. Nobody's going to be a good mother. Nobody's going to go plant a garden. Nobody's going to go hike in the woods. Nobody's going to enjoy the stars and the moon at night and all the beauty around us. Everyone is going to just believe in Obama and believe in the con game. And then they'll just bring you a new con of, oh, he's going to act as a dictator and take those restrictions off he put in. And then, of course, he doesn't do that. It's part of roping a dope. It's part of just keeping it going and going and going and going. So continuing here. Harvard study, Medicare actually increases ER visits. Yeah, instead of going to clinics that have even better medical care in most cases, private clinics that Obamacare basically is designed to shut down, that have the chest x-rays and have the doctors and the nurse practitioners and all the good people, that's where I go, and are nice, clean, newer facilities. Instead of doing that, people literally, in fact, everyone I know, people that have insurance, they end up going to the hospital. And, I mean, if your finger's cut off, you got to go to the hospital. Last time I went to the hospital, again, I just don't like being a second-class citizen. The illegal aliens were sitting there for an hour just not even being checked. It was just, you know, no speaking English, nothing. You know, here's my consul matricula, boom, you're right in. I had insurance. It was like, whoa, let's figure this out. Let's verify it for an hour. Let's jack it up. And I was like, I'm going to lose my finger. I had to threaten to sue them to get, okay, well, the doctor's been here. They'll attach your finger. And that's the type of stuff that's going on, this finger right here. That's the type of stuff that's going on in this country. Thousands of illegal immigrants show up at DMV offices to obtain driver's authorization cards. That's right. All over the country, California, you name it, the illegals are all being given driver's license, and they're allowed to use that to vote because no one checks if you're a citizen. Just with an address, you can vote. So that's how they're going to get our guns. The guns are banned in Mexico. And the client group coming in out of Mexico predominantly will vote for the Democrats or the Republicans. Look at Schwarzenegger is anti-gun. When he was governor and pro-open border and pro-carbon taxes and everything else horrible. So and the Republicans all loved him. They didn't care. As long as they could feel good and feel like they were in charge, it was all right. And they're talking about the governor running for president. The country will probably vote him in somewhere down the line. Brown, Moonbeam. And this is our lot in life. The global elite, exempt from taxes, exempt from regulations, living in armored, guarded compounds offshore and inside major cities and in rural redoubts like Whitefish and other areas. They're all exempt from everything, just like Rockefeller told Aaron Russo, you know, we're all going to have an ID card. Or a chip that says, kiss my patoot. We're above the law. And by the way, that's how this really works. And so they're exempt from the taxes. What are they going to do? They're going to jack them up on everybody else, bankrupt everyone, bring in a giant bankrupted third world population to politically vote, as long as they get food stamps and welfare and free goodies, along with the disenfranchised domestic population. They're going to vote to take everything we've got. Our children, our guns, our property, our security, our privacy, everything is being sucked dry by scientific criminals by design who make P.T. Barnum, the Wolf of Wall Street, Joseph Mengele, Bernie Madoff, the Keating Five look like angels. You're like, they make the angel of death look like an angel? Yes, the angel of death only killed thousands personally in his medical lab. The globalists, I mean, that's all the time I see about kids that go and have their tonsils out and they, you know, they die because flesh-eating bacteria get into their brain, through their throat, into their sinus. I mean, it's a death sentence. I've had friends, family, you name it, every year go in to have a minor procedure, and they're dead. Some numbers are up to a million die of hospital infections, but nobody's worried about that. You know, you think the flu kills 35,000? No, you go to the hospital for the flu, and then you die of everything else that's in there. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen. Stay with us. These are the plagues that are coming upon our judged country for the children we've killed. A lot of people wonder where my bumper music comes from. And I'd say about 90% of it is music I like. Another 5% is stuff that listeners tend to recommend. But another 5%, maybe even more, was my uncle, William Forrest Hammond, who died at 3:30 a.m. this morning in Tyler, Texas, where he was at a really nice hospital with good people. And I'm not going to talk about this anymore after this segment. I'm going to get into all the drone news, the Justice Department trying to block the Supreme Court's contraceptive mandate stay, IMF paper worms of savings tax and mass write-offs as West debt hits 200-year high. That's just some of what we're going to be breaking down here today. But just getting back to my uncle, it ties into so many things that my cousin, his son, got sick for a couple days and died of what they at first thought was flu, but then said they believed was some type of bacterial infection in his lungs. We've been talking for about a month about the mystery illness before it was even in the media. Now the former first lady, Barbara Bush, is in critical condition in a hospital with pneumonia. And it's a cocktail of viruses and drug-resistant bacteria. And there's just so much of it out there. And talking to Dr. Sherry Tenpenny, medical doctor yesterday, she was listing on air the mutations that the flu vaccine is actually causing, creating new flus. And how also that's then causing infections that then create a space that these drug-resistant bacteria can grow in. And what she was saying is exactly what the other medical doctors that were treating my uncle were saying. And no one could tell exactly what's doing all of this, but undoubtedly, if you had the number of deaths going on in Texas alone 5 years ago with the whole H1N1 hype meant to sell products and meant to get people to go get vaccinated with whatever else had been added to that shot, there was a bunch of stuff in there, very experimental. If you had one-tenth as many deaths, then it would have been total hysteria. So you know it's serious and you know it's bad when all the hospitals around the country are full, not just here in Texas, but this is the epicenter, it seems. When they're not just full, but there's people dying in them en masse. I mean, we're talking about 10 people or so in some major hospitals dying a week from this. 5 people, 6 people, 4 people in small hospitals. I mean, it is serious business, and it's barely even hit the news wires. And so my children hardly ever get sick. Took them 3 weeks to get over this. My dad was sick for a month and went and got tested, and they couldn't find out what it was because it's a microplasm. That's what fills in the gaps, according to Sherry Tenpenny and others. are these microscopic bacteria. Bacteria are already microscopic, but they're tiny compared to a regular bacteria. And it was being reported a few weeks ago when the deaths were starting to occur. Now there's pretty much a blackout on it. So we need to continue to investigate that. But I want to thank you all for your prayers for my uncle. I want to thank you for your prayers for this radio show and what we do here. And I know you're going through a lot out there as well. I know that we have some crew members here. Weldon's uncle is in a hospital, also a Vietnam fighter, a helicopter pilot. And they said that he's dying of Agent Orange. And very similar parallels to Weldon, who I had dinner with last night, and with some of the other crew, and with what's happened with my uncle. And they did say with my uncle, who never smoked, hardly ever drank, he'd drink a beer every once in a while on a hot day if he'd mowed the lawn. He was a football player at LSU and also track, really good shape, you know, looked younger. His body looked younger than my body, and I'm just 40 next month, and he was 68. But when they looked at his heart and things and lesions on it and on some other organs, they said, no, we've seen this in Vietnam veterans. That's Agent Orange lesions. And, of course, his firstborn son had holes in his heart, no history of deformity in our family, thank God. And they said, no, that was the Agent Orange. But then it got out of the system. It was usually the firstborn that would happen to right after he got back from Vietnam. It would be my first cousin, Flint, who it was pretty much exactly the same age as I, and he died. So just thank you, Monsanto that brought us Agent Orange, that they knew was a death sentence and really a chemical weapon to kill the North Vietnamese, which also blew back on our troops, just like DU does. Thank you, Monsanto. You've killed so many members of my family. And thank you for all the GMO. And thank you that you continue to kill all of us. Thank you so much. All right, I'm going to open the phones up specifically on anything you'd like to discuss. Toll-free number to join us, 800-259-9231, 800-259-9231. Almost everyone I know in the office, talking to them, has friends and family that can't breathe, that have lost 20, 30 pounds, that have been in the hospital for weeks, or who have been in bed for a week. I mean, this is some really bad pneumonia going around the country. And again, you notice there's almost no news coverage of it. And I have been involved with two family members dying in the last month with this. And I have talked to the doctors, and they say it's a virus that comes in, and then bacteria come in, and then another virus comes in. It is just a swarm of stuff. And then when it gets into the brain, it's goodbye. My uncle's body came back, but nobody home. Nobody home when he came back. They took him off the breathing assist, and he died in a day. And again, that's the reason I'm talking about it, is because it affects everybody. Barbara Bush hospitalized for pneumonia in Texas, and that's out of the New York Times. So this is serious, serious business, ladies and gentlemen. Serious. It's not just that it took out two members of my family. It is killing people all over the place. And I'll hear people in the grocery store line going, my husband's in the hospital. He can't breathe. They're going to have to ventilate him. And then I walk up and get a cup of coffee about a week and a half ago, seeing a performance of one of my daughters in a ballet. And the woman behind the counter was sitting there making coffee, talking about her boyfriend who had to go to the hospital the night before. I mean, that's just what I'm hearing everywhere. That's what I'm hearing all over the place. So mystery illness, big time, and we know it's not the flu, as they say. But Dr. Sherry Timpany says the flu has caused mutated viruses because they create a new virus, and it's not properly attenuated. It's very sophisticated information, but it's just amazing to see all this unfolding. But you've got your new Obamacare. Your new Obamacare to take care of you that's doubling and tripling prices, and the people that thought they signed up are going in and they're not signed up. Or if you did have insurance, now it takes hours to get in, even if you're bleeding to death. And they announced yesterday that the head of Health and Human Services and the federal government will dictate through the computers. We already knew this, but now it's official. They made the announcement that, yes, they will control what surgeries take place. The doctor will put, by law, into the database, and then the database will tell them what they can do. How's that sound? Forget the patient or forget the family having control with the doctor in that decision-making process and working with the nurses and coming to that conclusion. No, now all your data's public and Obama is your doctor, a eugenicist. Man, I tell you, that is a great deal, isn't it? Aren't you excited about that? Isn't it wonderful to have a big government that totally enslaves you and runs your life? By the way, we showed this video last year. The Air Force put out a video graphic, a animated illustration, film illustration, showing a drone flying over a city and releasing hundreds of hunter-killer robots that have a camera in them and also a gun. And they're only about 6 inches long with little bat wings. And now they've come out and announced that indeed that's what they actually have and that they will use this against anybody and everybody. Can you imagine the criminals that run the world when they have systems like this? And it gets better. They say they're going to deploy chemical weapons. Well, they're already doing that with the chemtrails and the weather modification. And it then spies on you. And then it calls in some of the other drone swarms to then attack. And there's actual footage in their rendering of them watching terrorists, that is anybody that resists them, and then taking them out. Now let's move forward here to the Daily Mail. Military drones set to get stronger chemical weapons, because they're already preparing them with tear gas for you and your family, with your taxpayer paid for money. Military drones set to get stronger chemical weapons and could soon make their own decisions during missions. Again, 4 years ago, the British and the United States launched drones that are autonomous and decide who to kill. I want to make that clear that that's what's going on. The U.S. Department of Defense revealed its unmanned systems integrated roadmap, setting out its technology aims. And again, whatever they tell you about in the next 25 years means they already have it. Its plans include drone bombs that can hunt in swarms, that's a quote, from a mothership. Next generation unmanned aircraft will likely be equipped with better sensors and navigational equipment, plus superior autonomous systems. And in that same Air Force video, towards the end, it actually shows the drone, the mini drone that was dropped from the swarm, actually kill the man who has a rifle. And then in law enforcement video that came out earlier this year that Paul Watson wrote about, the Drudge Report and others picked up, it actually showed them taking on two American gun owners when guns are banned, and it shows two Duck Dynasty type guys literally in a field shelling each other a rifle, and the drone, of course, brings the police in on them. So this is it. And you're like, well, the police will never be able to control this. Ladies and gentlemen, the police down in Katy, Texas, got a $600,000 drone helicopter that was about 8 feet long and crashed it on the first takeoff because just 2 years ago, they didn't have proper autonomous software. I bought the Parrot 2 for my son for Christmas that cost $300. So we could also beta test it here in the office. I'm going to put a video out of it today. And the Parrot 2, we bought a Parrot 1 a year ago and shot it in the video, drone shot down over Texas, using an iPad to control it. It was still hard to control it. My son, the first time out of the box, flew it for 10 minutes and landed it safely and has flown it 50 times until he finally crashed it into a tree. We have to put a new propeller on it. And it's a four-prop, $300 unit with HD video for $300. HD camera. HD video, beams it back to the iPad, $300, and it could be weaponized right now. Even SPF Russian has shown a year ago drones that cost a few thousand dollars with automatic weapons on them firing. And the police departments now will be able to set their target via face scan or address, hit one button, and a squadron of 15 attack bots will take off at current technology level for about $10,000, and they will go and kill everyone. that they're targeting. Okay, you have to understand this, ladies and gentlemen. This is the reality. And this is the end of humanity. This is why the globalists are so arrogant. This is why they're so out of control. This is why they don't care. They have incredible life extension technologies already rolling out. Look at Dick Cheney. No one used to live from what he went through. Having a bionic heart pump for 2 years and then getting a new heart. Now he looks super healthy. You're not going to get access to that. That's a big hoax that, oh, he got regular medical care. That was someone incredibly compromised. He was on a ventilator for 3 months, still survived because of the technology they have. They don't want you to have that. And they've decided to take over civilization and society. And if you act stupid and if you act lazy and if you act like you don't care, they're going to win. Let's go to the next article on technology here. Wall-climbing gecko robot could scuttle in space. See, the decision is humans aren't going to space. Robots are going to space, and the elite and Google believe they're going to merge with the machines. I don't know if that's true or not. That's their goal. They have set the course for our world and our planet. Is that something you want? Do you want to just cede the entire future to them so you can go watch NFL football? And again, it's these same wall-scuttling robots that have the dual use as combat bots. And this is what you're seeing. I was told by Marines, high level, if colonels high level, that they had killer robots better than what you see in the movie Terminator 15 years ago. And then I, years later, saw some of what he told me about actually declassified partially. I was told they're going to roll out microwave guns on the backs of Humvees. A couple years later, that came out. I was told, and then later he said, and then there's stuff even more crazy. I was told, it doesn't even matter. And the issue is, this is not to keep us safe. This is pointed at us. This is pointed at controlling civilization and society. You know, there is some good news, though, in the culture war. Then we're going to go to your phone calls. Television blackouts possible in three NFL playoff cities this weekend because they can't sell the tickets. And then you know if they don't sell the tickets, there's a blackout. And then all the narcissist football players are begging people to buy the tickets. Let me explain something to you. The country's in a depression by design. Agenda 21 is the name of the game. Bankrupt is by design for control. A. B. People that do have money are boycotting you because of the TSA genital groping at the games and because of the anti-gun Obamacare promotion. When you've got Obama, who symbolizes a government with a 6% approval rating, as your mascot and not Hank Williams Jr., you're going to turn people off. And so herein lies the secret. If we culturally steel ourselves, I don't mean steel like take something away, like steel, make ourselves stoic and strong. If we realize the system's corrupt and boycott everything that's anti-liberty, promote everything that is liberty, we will take America back just like we did with the Duck Dynasty fight. When Roe v. Wade went through in 73, because nobody could see an ultrasound, now we have them, the majority of people in this country were pro-abortion. Today, every poll shows it's flipped. 65, 70, even higher with young people are against it. We're winning the culture war despite everything the system is doing. And it's the same thing with the NFL. And they just hope we all become decadent and decide the way you get ahead, and that's the message of the Wolf of Wall Street, is by screwing people. And it doesn't matter. You know, if you screw people, you'll still win in the end. And it's fun and it's cute and it's good. And the FBI is good. They came and stopped Leonardo DiCaprio's character, who we've looked into. And of course, he actually went after a billionaire in Alabama and screwed him. And that's why the FBI was told to go after him, was because he went after an insider. He screwed rich people. He targeted rich people and not poor people. If you target poor people with penny stocks or the general public, that's fine. You don't target, like the Wolf of Wall Street did, rich people. And I was sitting there watching the movie last night with Weldon and Gucciardi. And at the end, I said, watch, I haven't followed his story. I know some about it. Let's go look it up. He targeted rich people, and they sicked the FBI on him. Because you could steal $1 trillion, and the FBI would do nothing. They're told who they can go after by the Justice Department. It's literally run by these people. And we went and looked it up, and there it was in mainline news articles that he went after a billionaire globalist in Alabama banker and basically ripped him off for $25 million. And they said, you give me that money back or it's over. And the Wolf of Wall Street told him take a hike, and you saw what happened. So that's how this works. That's the rules with the globalist, is you only screw the little guys. You don't touch the big guys. It's mafia rules. And that's how this stuff operates. You know, it's a true story with Bo Dietl involved in it. Bo Dietl even plays himself. It's amazing. And that's how the world really works, ladies and gentlemen. I've been taken up to the top of the mountain many times. That's what the establishment does. And told, the public are idiots. They don't want your help. They would tear you apart in a minute. They're worse than we are as the establishment. At least we run things to control it. And you should join us if you want to try to influence things and have any power. Because, you know, we're not all bad, and we want you to be part of this. And people say, well, why don't you say who did that? It's happened many times. No, if I do that as a journalist, then I won't have people contact me that way. They don't do it anymore. It's been many, many years since I've been offered to sell out to the New World Order. I mean, I've been contacted by some high-powered folks, and they said, if you, you know, just back off a little, you're going to be more successful and all the rest of it. But, I mean, I'm way past that, folks. I'm way past ever even being able to think about compromising any. I mean, I realize that this system's coming down, and this system's pure evil, and I spiritually don't want to be connected to it in any way. Now, nobody's perfect. Corruption's everywhere, and you could literally kill yourself trying to, you know, be like Jesus. But I'm a man, and I'm not perfect, but I morally try to be good. And there's a difference between trying to be morally good, trying to be accurate, trying to be right, controlling your more worldly, cunning side, even though you want to defeat people that have done wrong things to you, and turning the other cheek, which I found is very, very successful. If you can turn the other cheek and the fight doesn't really matter, that always turns out better. Now, if someone corners you, it's a different situation. We're going to go to break, come back to your calls in this segment, the next segment. Then I'm going to get into U.S. Justice Department, speaking of them, opposes block on Obamacare contraception mandate, is basically trying to order the Supreme Court to back off on that. Huge news on the 200-year debt bubble we've now reached from the London Telegraph, and a lot more. And some more good news, 70 new anti-abortion laws okayed in 22 states, second most ever. People are taking action. Flower Mound Mayor declares 2014 Year of the Bible. I got a bunch of other culture war news. Duck Dynasty releases its own line of guns. See, we take over the economy with what we do. We vote with our dollars. You vote with the globalist. You support them. You destroy yourself. Now, ladies and gentlemen, speaking of that, we have the best products out there for health, wellness, information warfare, Second Amendment, you name it, InfoWarsStore.com for the books, the videos, the t-shirts. InfoWarsLife.com is where you find the Survival Shield Nation Iodine. Proprietary. Now, the government just bought 14 million dosages of the bound kind of garbage iodine that's still better than nothing. We sell that as well. But the point is, we have the proprietary Survival Shield, pure nascent iodine at the lowest price at InfoWarsLife.com. And we also have, in a 2-ounce bottle, twice the size, the Fluoride Shield that has the nascent iodine in it as well, but also five other key ingredients known to detoxify the fluoride, heavy metals, boring, you name it. InfoWarsLife.com. And the good news is we've got plenty of the Fluoride Shield. We're about to sell out of the InfoWars Life Survival Shield Pure Nascent Iodine. So better get your order in right now at InfoWarsLife.com or 888-253-3133. I remember my uncle who died today. He would call me every few weeks or send me a letter, and he says, you ought to play Jimi Hendrix Along the Watchtower. This is recommended by him. Been on the show for about 16, 17 years. Even that very audio file you're hearing. And He recommended that to Bob Dylan song you heard earlier. I guess it's funny today we're kind of going in the computer into stuff that was put there many years ago and transferred over in automation. We're playing automated music today. And it's funny that it's the playlist that my uncle put together. All right, folks, we are back live. They listen to this stuff over in Vietnam flying helicopters. Let's go to your phone calls, ladies and gentlemen. Ken in Illinois, you're on the air. Go ahead.
God bless, Alex. This is an honor. I was a real estate analyst at Tony Resco's bank in Chicago. Barack Obama was literally a crook when he was a senator 3 years before he was elected president.
Oh, yeah, that all came out. They're total gangsters. Yeah, go ahead.
Right. Tony Resco is doing a 10-and-a-half-year stretch right now. He's about 3.5 years into it. So he's in the joint for a long time. Resco paid $625 for land that was worth only $500,000. And then on that same day, Obama, from the same seller, bought the mansion next door.
No, I know. That even came out in news, but you're saying you worked at the bank and saw all that. Yeah, no, Resco went to jail basically for the exact same stuff Obama was doing, and they were two ponies in the stable for governor or senator or El Presidente by Axelrod.
Right, and Rod Blagojevich is all in the middle of it, and he's doing a big stretch, 14 years. Rod Blagojevich is in Colorado right now for 14 years. The FBI met with me about Obama, and there was possibly a grand jury against Obama. Obama could be in the clink right now. He really literally could be in prison right now as opposed to living in the White House. And that's what I met with the FBI about. He took a $125,000 kickback from a guy who's in prison right now.
Well, I know a lot of that came out, and you sound credible. And again, I'm not saying all the FBI agents are bad themselves. They try to do investigations, and they get blocked, like on Fast and Furious, by the guy involved in it, John, you know, Attorney General Eric Holder. I was thinking of John P. Holder, and another, you know, guy in the White House running all sorts of nasty operations. And I mean, it's well known that Chicago's total mafia run. Where is all this going now?
Well, I was interviewed by Jerome Corsi and the Washington Times and several other sources. And there's really not much other than I have a key TAM lawsuit against the bank. They were running a massive racketeering scheme to defraud the FDIC. And it's much bigger. A lot of these bank collapses that you're seeing were intentional looting of the banks, including Resco's bank. And Obama had to know what was going on at Resco's bank. Resco was his best friend, essentially, him and his wife.
That's right, and Resco did get, what is it, 10.5 years. There it is in the Chicago Sun-Times. I'm glad you called in about that subject. People go watch a movie like The Wolf of Wall Street that they say is incredibly accurate down to the smallest details, and they go, how could someone be that wild and crazy? This guy's a good guy compared to these sharks, from what I've studied, no. The Wolf of Wall Street got burned because he went after big guys. And I'm not defending him. He's a monster. But compared to these people, I mean, they're involved in everything, folks. They get money off the kids that get taken by CPS all over the country. That money goes through the big orphanage groups. They literally are kidnappers. The government is criminal. You may live in a county or city that's not totally criminal, but it will be soon. That's what tyranny's about. Global corporate mafia is taking over. In Illinois, another call from Illinois. You're on the air, Hank.
Hello, Mr. Jones. How are you doing?
Pretty good, brother. What's on your mind today?
Oh, nothing. I just wanted to thank you for all the stuff you've done to wake everybody up. And another thing is, my father, about a year ago, he still is the chief of security in a major courthouse out here. And I told him to go to Infowars.com. 3 weeks later, the whole courthouse was taken over by Homeland Security. And that's who he works for now. I was just wondering if you had knowledge about that, sir.
Well, I know that the feds are pretty much outright federalizing county, city, states. If they can get the county and the city to go along with it and the state to stand down, they completely take it over. And in areas they control, they're doing that. And then you have to remember, the feds themselves are run by the offshore globalists. So this is an occupation. But no, I was not aware of your particular area.
Oh. All right, well, I appreciate it. I just didn't know if I was a conspiracy theorist or not. And I thank you, sir. And everybody should listen to Alex Jones. Thank you. Bye.
Thanks a lot, buddy. You kind of said that like Hank Hill. Everybody should listen to Alex Jones. Let's talk to another caller here. Let's talk to Lauren, who loves Obamacare. Lauren in California, go ahead.
Hi, Alex. Thank you for taking my call. My husband and I are some of those people who have lost their health insurance due to Obamacare. We both had policies that were affordable that had, you know, a $12,000 premium. Now the premiums, deductible, the $12,000 deductible, now the premiums have quadrupled, so it's more than a house payment for both of us, and each of us has a $40,000 deductible. Needless to say, we don't have health insurance.
And they don't care. That's fine. Now they'll just come after your bank account and garnish your wages and take your tax refund, as they're now announcing. Doesn't that sound like Affordable Care Act to you?
Of course not. Yeah. You know, and so we just take responsibility for our health. We do the nascent iodine you have. It's a great product.
Thank you
so much for it. And we see a chiropractor once a month, and I have not been sick in over 20 years.
Well, I tell you, they're trying to shut down supplements this year. They've announced that just across the board. They've already done it to a great extent in Europe under Codex Alimentarius. They are going after the chiropractors. They're going after even clinics that have medical doctors that are staying outside the system. It is a total takeover. I mean, we saw a case in Texas that was in the news where Humana went up 539% on a family. My dad's premiums have now doubled. Mine have gone way up with Blue Cross Blue Shield. I need to do a piece on that, showing my own insurance. And it's just such a loving thing they did for us. Actually, it's totally sick. Do you think they can get away with this?
No. No, I think there's a major revolution coming. And the interesting thing is I work part-time at a hospital, and nobody there is happy. And I talk to the little people. I don't talk to the head honchos. I talk to the little people because they're my friends. And they're not happy. They're all losing their insurance, and they are hospital staff.
Well, you know what the Obama administration, MSNBC, and a professor yesterday said. They said that's because you're racist. I mean, if you're white, you're the reason Obamacare isn't working. So do you want to apologize for people not being able to get surgery and stuff because it's your fault?
Nope. Not my fault.
I know it isn't your fault, and that's how crazy it is that they then arrogantly blame us and say it's our fault. Thank you for the call, Lauren. All right, Raider, Sean, Wesley, Steve, and many others, your calls are coming up. But for about 45 minutes, we're going to have Charlotte Iserbyt on to talk about Common Core and the brainwashing that's going on. And then we'll continue with the latest battles over abortion and then what's happening with the Second Amendment. Alex Jones. Cover some of the top breaking news and go to our special guest, major whistleblower on education. But first off, London Guardian reports U.S. Justice Department opposes block on Obamacare contraception mandate. Administration calls on Justice Sotomayor to dissolve her stay and to make the Catholic Church basically promote abortion. So there is that news. I mentioned this yesterday, but it's so important tying into all the other news that we see. Feds preparing for violence targeting Social Security buildings. $58 million for security just at two facilities. That is such a big deal. And here's why they're getting ready. IMF paper warns of savings tax and mass write-offs as West debt hits 200-year high. Hyperinflation looming. Much of the Western world will require defaults and savings tax and higher inflation to clear the way for recovery. See, they've decided to go the way of inflation as debt levels reach a 200-year high, according to a new report by the International Monetary Fund. And, of course, they're the authors of much of that. So what do you expect? So that's just some of the news on that front. We're going to be breaking that down more coming up. Also, we're going to be looking at citing EU. Italy orders journalist to promote homosexual agenda. That's out of the New American Magazine, and LifeSite News broke it. And remember, Reuters reported, along with AFP 2 days ago, that they ruled that a 60-year-old man can grab your 11-year-old child out of the backyard and rape them. And if the child tells social workers they enjoyed it, it's love, and you get let out of jail. So they're coming for our kids, and if you don't let them do it, it's going to be pedophobia, and they're going to come kill you. The SWAT teams are. So, and I'm serious. They're banning homeschooling worldwide. They're hunting down Christians. It's here. It's here. And this is this pure evil agenda of Agenda 21, which is basically what the Jacobin French try to do in the French Revolution, the opposite of our revolution. Overthrow the family. Overthrow God. Have a nine-day week. Change the calendar. Just turn loose total evil on Earth. That is their goal. That is what they push. That is what they stand for. So we are going to be breaking all of this and more down today. For most of the hour, we're joined by Charlotte Iserbyt, the best-selling author. And it's been out of print, but she's come out with a smaller edition now. The Deliberate Dumbing Down of America. It's still very thick with all these graphics and documents. We sell it at InfoWarsStore.com. And the book, if you want to understand why they're dumbing everybody down, is close to 500 pages long. She was the head of policy, number two position, at the Department of Education in the Ronald Reagan administration. And she was a leading educator, and also her, what was it, dad and grandfather had been in Skull and Bones. So she was also a kind of an insider. She's also the lady that leaked all the stuff to Anthony Sutton that exposed Skull and Bones. And you know, also her dad and grandfather were good guys, and everybody there was bad. In fact, her dad told her about that. So the whole point is that there's not all bad people in the system. And there's always time to expose what's going on. But she's a whistleblower. And I wanted to get her on. She also has a new DVD set out that we don't sell yet, but is available on her site. We'll tell you how to get that. Exposing the Global Road to Ruin Through Education. And this is shot in 2012, 2013 at two conferences. All educators need to see this to understanding what they've done. And then she has another booklet out for educators, Back to Basics Reform, or OBE Skinnered International Curriculum. Now, we've gotten her on about the master plan and what's behind it and where it's going, but in her book, she shows the government documents where they said, by the time they're done with it, your child won't be able to talk. And they admit, they call it brainwashing in Department of Education graphics, cartoons they did, just like the NSA documents came out this week, where they were calling iPhone users dumb zombies and laughing at how they'd turned America into 1984. So it shows them slowly federalizing the schools and then making the kids mean and dumbed down and turning it into Big Brother National Information Distribution Center, Imperial International Propaganda System, that's the youth brigades, Our Lady of the Benevolent Dictatorship, One World Global Training Corps, and then Interplanetary Carbon Unit Reprogramming Pod. This is from the 80s. Literal biological android. But look, he's happy now, and he's plugged into a computer. So, and again, we're going to Iserbyt in a moment. Her Skype just dropped. But that's the point of what's going on with this book and this material. So, without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, this is a total takeover. 2 + 2 = 5. Teach 5-year-olds how to be transgender. If they can get away with that, they can do anything. That's what this is. The school says your child can be vaccinated against your will or have an abortion against your will. This is the state taking over, as MSNBC has said. Ohio with bills to basically outlaw homeschooling, send CPS after everybody. They're coming. They're coming. But we can push back if we recognize they're not misguided liberals. And they've got the Republican leadership with them and Bill Gates. These are scientific takeover experts. Okay, joining us is Charlotte Iserbyt. Charlotte, thank you so much for coming on. Break down the basics and then get into Common Core for people so they understand it.
Well, Alex, I'm very pleased that everybody's focusing on... Well, I'm not pleased that much. I think it's normal that parents would be focusing on Common Core. And there's a lot of money out there supporting their focus from the neoconservative Trotskyites. It's a big bandwagon across the country to keep parents and teachers focused on Common Core. We've had Common Core ever since certainly the 1970s. It came out of the original goals, which are standards, right, came out of the Northwest Regional Lab. And that's in my little book, Back to Basics Reform, actually, the information there, which was, let's just point out that everything I've ever written, the reason that nobody knows what happened, is that everything I ever wrote was boycotted, not by normally, you know, the left would, but by the neoconservative Trotskyites. Every single organization in this country boycotted my Back to Basics Reform, which I wrote after I got myself fired from the Department of Ed, full of documentation, warning Americans of exactly what's happening now. That little book, only $10. And then I wrote Deliberate Dumbing Down of America, because that little book was boycotted. People said they didn't understand it, huh? So then I wrote the biggie, 700 pages. That was boycotted, but is a free download at deliberatedumbingdown.com. So there's no excuse for any American or foreigner, for that matter, because the foreigners know that that book is correct, too. I had an interesting email yesterday from a teacher in Bosnia who asked how we could possibly get it into more languages, the Deliberate Dumbing Down of America. But anyway, they boycotted. Then they boycotted the U.S.-Soviet Education Agreement information I got out. They boycotted the latest abridged version, which you're selling, right, the Deliberate Dumbing Down of America, because they don't want anybody to know that it's not Common Core, it's unelected boards brought about by school choice funded with your tax money. They don't want anybody to know that. That's the issue. That is the issue, believe it or not, even I can't believe it, that is going to bring our country down. When private education, religious education, and homeschool education accepts a tax one penny of tax money to run their schools, they will be completely controlled. Even if they kill Common Core, they will have to put it in anyway, because they won't have any elected boards.
Well, Charlotte, let me quantify what you just said so eloquently, because as a parent, I've experienced it. They wreck public education, federalize it, globalize it. That's the Common Core. But they've already gotten all the private schools and most of the homeschoolers to adopt Common Core. I can't find a homeschool academy or a Christian school that doesn't literally have the handouts from Michelle Obama on what my kids should eat. They've taken, just like with the churches and the new freedom initiatives, with the pharmaceuticals and the faith-based initiative, they've already taken it almost all over. And now they're saying they're going to hunt down the true homeschoolers. Go ahead.
Oh, absolutely. And I want people, they've really got to go and get this 8-disc set. There are 7 discs or videos, presentations, about 18 hours of videotaping of the leading, we call them, and most respected education researchers in the country over the past 50 years. We had one marvelous researcher come in from California to Maine last year who fought the planning, programming, budgeting management system, which is really total quality management, which took over all the schools of America and turned them into brainwashing factories. Her marvelous gal, she's still fighting, and she does a beautiful presentation. Mary Thompson is her name. We have Samuel Blumenfeld dealing with the fact that all the Rockefeller brothers can't read because they went through, they went to the Lincoln School in New York, which didn't have them starting to read until they were probably in second or third grade, and taught them the wrong way because it was all John Dewey. Marvelous what Blumenfeld has there.
Yeah, my son could read when he was 3. So could my dad.
Please don't tell me, because I've got problems in my own family where reading is not being taught at an early age, and it should be. We've got Rosa Corey came in because she's, of course, Agenda 21. We met Rosa for the first time last year, and she did a wonderful, we've got a wonderful presentation by Rosa. We've got Kelly Nelson. She absolutely blows the whistle for a good hour on the Trotskyite neoconservatives who have been behind this agenda.
Let's explain it. They wreck. They federalize and wreck public schools, which is the fire. Then they throw us into neocon corporate schools that are hell itself, all by design. They've wrecked the public schools. Now they're going to move on to everything else while saying we're running from Common Core. The answer is Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Charlotte Iserbyt is our guest. We'll about 50 after. Then I'll take your phone calls that are holding. We have another guest coming up to look at the black genocide program taking place here in the U.S. by the left, particularly. Quebec study, concealed carry results in fewer murders. These results suggest that restrictive concealed weapons laws may cause an increase in gun-related murders at that level. And that is the government of Quebec. Meanwhile, you have the head of Interpol coming out a few months ago and saying the answer is arming the general public. 2 + 2 = 4 in the real world. But in Common Core land, Affordable Care Act triples your health care and lowers your quality and lets the government share your data. Or Chicago takes all the guns, crime rate goes up. This is why they have to dumb you down so that common sense can be basically abolished. That's what they talk about in 1984 under ENGSOC, or English socialism, was the plan, which was a real plan, by the way, as part of the Fabian Socialists, Eric Blair, a.k.a., of course, George Orwell, was to restrict the language down to nothing, to basically grunts, or plus, or minus, or double plus, or triple minus, just chirping like a parrot. This is the Skinnerian brainwashing that Charlotte Iserbyt is a pioneer, along with John Taylor Gatto and others, exposing it. And if you realize they've wrecked public education, they're bringing in total increased brainwashing. It's just, it's gotten so crazy now. Here's how to dress. Here's how to have anal sex. Here's 2 + 2 = 5. That's why people are freaking out over Common Core. But then the answer, they say, are these Bill and Melinda Gates takeovers. So, Charlotte, continue breaking down what's really happening.
Well, I'd like to point out for the people researching Common Core that in the mid-70s, you know, they think that what they've got is bad. In the mid-70s, we had health education here in Maine, and it required the students to know the three types of sexual intercourse, including with animals. Okay, now let's go past that. Folks, look. What you have now, it's Marxist curriculum. It's no different from what was planned in 1934. By the Carnegie Corporation, and it's at americandeception.com. The book is called Conclusions and Recommendations for the Social Studies. Just type the word conclusions in there and read that book where they say right there that the Carnegie Corporation and other tax-exempt foundations would use the schools to change America to a planned economy, and it even talks about taking our land. So wait now, let's not get down, you know, just focusing all our attention on Common Core. We can't do that. We've got to get into the real research, and that is what the 8-disc project is all about. You have not only the videotaped presentations of all these great people, but you have written submissions from people like Ed Griffin, who interviewed Norman Dodd, who was told in that interview, Norman Dodd was told by the Ford Foundation head Gaither that they were meant to use their money, the tax-exempt foundations, to use their money to merge the United States with the Soviet Union, which is exactly what is happening now, because the curriculum that is going in, nobody can challenge me on this, is all Soviet polytech workforce training for a global economy to spin off profits for the global elite to use your children. And that is exactly what's been going on ever since the beginning of the last century. Tragedy and Hope, Quigley pointed it out in Tragedy and Hope. Most important thing to remember of all, once you get that in your head, you got it. Both parties are the same at the top. They have the identical agenda. Look, when you have Lou Gerstner, former IBM, Arne Duncan, leftist, huh, head of Department of Ed, Obama, and the tax-exempt Heritage Foundation, conservative, huh, that drafted the North American Free Trade Agreement, when you have all of them on board on Common Core, they say they're opposed to it, but they're not, because they need it for school choice. You need school choice because those are little charter schools that are international, by the way. They're not new. They're in Russia. They're called contract schools. They're in bed with the corporations. The whole thing is a public-private merger. You can call it whatever you want: communism, socialism, fascism, communitarianism. That's what it is. And it came out of the White House. I'm sorry to tell you, Ronald Reagan. I was the liaison with the White House for public-private partnerships. That was the one agreement, one project that allowed the school to work agenda to move forward, bringing the corporations into our schools to decide who's going to do this, who's going to do that, et cetera. We haven't gotten into the actual workforce training yet. We're into the brainwashing now. That's Common Core, out of UNESCO, by the way, Common Core. Mm-hmm. Okay. That's where we're at.
All right, we're going to come back and talk more about that, ladies and gentlemen, but it's so essential people understand we're not even endorsing the public schools. When they were local, that was a different thing. They've taken them, federalized them. Now they're wrecking it and giving the alternative their tyranny.
We're on the march. The empire.
We're going back to Charlotte Iserbyt, the greatest education whistleblower ever. And there she was, the head of policy of the Department of Education. Of course, Ronald Reagan was just a figurehead, but the system was there using that agenda. That's why they get more done when Republicans are in power for socialism and gun control than they even get when Democrats are in, except now with Obama. I mean, I hate to think what the next one's going to be like as they've turned the office into a dictatorship. But I want to ask Charlotte where we're going if we don't turn this around here in a moment. What's frustrating is when you've read the Carnegie Endowment documents, when you've read the committee hearings from Congress, you can go to her websites. They have the books for free, including books written by globalists. In one case, she was offered basically unlimited millions of dollars to turn over a book that they were able to secure through their inside connections, because the globalists write these books that are only for top technicians, like Tragedy and Hope. And we'll get her to talk about that in a minute when we go back to her. But it's all up on the sites where they lay it all out. It's not like I know what's coming because I just had a vision at 2 a.m. That's what's frustrating. They literally, in the 80s, were saying humans will be known as carbon units and won't be able to talk if we let you live. I mean, these people, it is so mega evil that it's hard to believe, but it's all happening. And by the way, we sell the book Behind the Green Mask that she was mentioning is interviewed in her film in her 8-disc set with Rosa Corey, and it's the best little primer breaking it down, but it's total enslavement through the economy, where the globalists are above the law and exempt from all their laws. It is absolute discrimination of the greatest magnitude. Now, briefly, ladies and gentlemen, we are running out of the proprietary, pure, nascent iodine that has just done wonders for myself and my family and the thyroid that protects you from a lot of these isotopes. We haven't sold out of it in a month. We are basically going to be sold out if it keeps selling like it is by Monday. So if you want Survival Shield, InfoWars Life, Nation Iodine, you've heard the rave reviews from listeners, and all the things it does, just go watch the video, read the medical links that are out there, the information, the research, consult your physician, and then check it out, Survival Shield, InfoWars Life, Nation Iodine. Now, even if that sells out, the good news is we have the fluoride shield in a double the size bottle that also has nascent iodine in it with five other key compounds known to get fluoride out, heavy metals, you name it, other members of the borane family, so, or the halogen family. So it's all there. See the information. See the interviews with the doctors and scientists and nutritionists at InfoWarsLife.com. And thank you for your support also, but we have committed to you to bring you the highest quality products to InfoWarsLife.com to be truly independent and fund our own operation. Most revolutionaries rob banks to fund their operations. That's what the communists do. We're free market, and the mainstream media criticizes us for being free and independent, selling high quality products like the Chiapas, High Mountain, shade grown in organic volcanic soil coffee that was my favorite coffee. I finally, after years, found a source to the farmers. We have it, and people have tried it. They're blown away. Wake Up America Coffee at InfoWarsLife.com. Two different blends. Medium roast, my favorite. People agree it's their favorite, or they say it's excellent. I mean, it's all up to taste, but InfoWarsLife.com or call toll-free 888-253-3139. The federal government just ordered 14 million doses. 14 million doses of iodine because of what's happening at Fukushima and all the reports of that and the radiation wave coming our way and all of this. That's how I, 5-6 months ago, discovered True Nation iodine of this proprietary type, did such wonders for me. I said, I want to basically, you know, buy you to where I can put this out. That's what I want to bring my people. I want to make sure you've got enough of it and you can supply it. And that's what we've done. So InfoWarsLife.com. All right, enough from me. Going back to Charlotte Iserbyt, who was the head of policy, Department of Education in the 1980s, and was able to get this information in her book, The Deliberate Dumbing Down of America, that breaks down what's happening. But again, the globalists will use their own created crisis to bring in the solution. It's not that the government-run education's good. It's that their solution is Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, Carnegie Endowment, Ford Foundation, to come in, and it's the same stuff that's being taught in the public schools. They just take the best students and say, aren't you lucky? And then you pay to put your kids in a brainwashing camp. So, again, they wreck the schools. They know you're going to run. They've got the next scam. Charlotte, keep breaking it down.
Well, I'd like to point out that there's going to be absolutely no, there's no difference between what they want to put in under the charter schools, the tax-supported private education, the complete takeover of private education, and destruction of the public school system, because the charter schools are pulling the students out of the public school system. Now, I've never been one to defend public education. I do defend a lot of the teachers, because I know what they've had to go through the years, and so much of exposing the global road to ruin through education. We have interviews with public school teachers. That's why it makes it so special. The people involved in this product of ours are not affiliated with any political group in this country. We are all independent. We've been working with public school teachers. We have an administrator right from Austin, Texas, you know, who gives out the information on what they're doing in Austin with the charter schools. But what I want to point out here is that our disc set has a recommendation in it, exposing the global road to ruin through education, which you can get at Amazon or at my website. Click on Amazon link there. Has the last disc, I believe, is the toolkit, a to-do list, what we can do to take back America. Now, I don't know of any other product out there that really has a list with 24 or 25 items on it. It can be done, but you're going to have to understand that we're between a rock and a hard place. The rock is really lethal. That is the corporate side, with the governors, with the president, with the Heritage Foundation, with all of the phony Trotskyites. And by the way, Alex, I don't believe Reagan was a figurehead. He was very deeply involved in signing the agreements with the Soviet Union. He was in Moscow. He did it. Ed Curran, the greatest educator, wanted to get rid of his own office in the department, the NIE, was fired by Reagan. I can't defend Reagan on this, but I don't defend one single president since Coolidge.
He was known as Red Ronnie when he was a communist before he became a supposed conservative. You might, Charlotte, mention to people who the Trotskyites are. For those that don't know, Trotsky was run out by Stalin. They came to Mexico and created the neoconservative movement and took over.
And he was responsible for killing 4 million Russians, too, if people would like to know that. Now, in the disc set, there's one full hour. Kelly Nelson from Tennessee, who's been researching the phony right, the neocon Trotskyites, for 40 years. She gets up there and lists every single group in this country and every single individual who have been involved pretending they love America and the Constitution, working with the Council on Foreign Relations, which, you know, the CFR, as I said before, CFR, Heritage, Obama, and Gerstner, all in bed with the same agenda to destroy our academic system, tear it down, and put in the Soviet system, which is what Reagan was involved in doing. I have all the documents, okay? Now, the school system going in, folks, we have it. We had a pilot in my little town here in Dresden, Maine. It's all over the country now. It's international. It's called Reinventing School Coalition. It takes away all grades, A, B, C, D, It takes away K through 12. It takes away the units for math, for law, et cetera. It uses the Malcolm Baldrige Award, Total Quality Management. That is the system going in across the country. It was first experimented on, and I was noticing after I speak, you've got something to do with the minorities, how they've been experimented on. On my website, I have a paper called Experimentation on Minorities. They use the minorities from 1965 on with the Skinner method, OBE. They didn't care whether they failed and went down the tubes. Once they got the method and the restructuring of American education, no grades, all this I've been talking about, perfected, they're giving it to all of us now. And it comes.
No, that's on record. The wrecking the family, the turning people into all this horrible stuff, that was done to the minorities, and now they're going to move it into everything and have, whether you're black, white, Hispanic, middle class, and have money, you're going to beg to put your kid into the fancy brainwashing that was already been used to wreck the inner city.
You have a very, that's very good. I mean, that was the Chicago Mastery Learning Plan. And the fellow,
which Obama helped push.
Oh, yeah. Well, I don't know, but it was way back 1968.
No, but I'm saying Obama took those later programs and helped destroy the private schools in Chicago.
Well, yeah, that's true. But
public schools.
This Lee Shulman, the professor involved in the Chicago Mastery Learning disaster, which was referred to by Education Week as a human disaster of enormous proportions, that man is working with a Catholic Education Association to put Common Core into the Catholic schools with his spin. This is the man responsible for the destruction of the inner city schools between 1970 and 1980.
But Charlotte, let's be clear, it's not a disaster, as you know, in the documents. It is planned.
Absolutely. Every single thing is planned. And I hope that inner city minority people are listening to this today because they were used. Again, they're always used. The whole integration thing managed to use them. And I might point out, Alex, talking about the order at Yale, thank you. I managed for the first time to see that great interview that the guys came up here to do. I saw it last week, and the one with Sutton and me and all that, and,
yes.
And got almost 500,000 hits. I was amazed. But I found another smoking gun there, and he was very responsible for the black experimentation on the black so-called integration and all, and it's absolutely amazing that I had not found this before, and I'm so excited about it. I can't even remember his name right now, but it is in the book. It's in the it's in one of the little black books. And he came after Francis Keppel, and he was a commissioner. And I'm looking right now for the papers on him, and I can't find it.
But what's important is on your websites, give those out. You have a lot of the books and stuff totally free, including their books that they fought to not have you publish. Online. Tell folks about some of those books.
Well, yes. It was the Reese Committee hearings, 3,000 pages.
As a book, yeah.
Reese Committee hearings that I bought from someone who worked for the Intelligence Committee, for that committee that did the investigation of the tax-exempt foundations. And I finally bought it. But he's the one that was offered any amount of money by the minions of the foundations for that one copy. Because they didn't want the American people to know what had gone on during those hearings. And I mentioned earlier, you know, that the importance.
Well, give the website out, because we're going to go to the site and show people on TV right now, not just radio. We're going to show them that document so they can go and get it, because it shouldn't just sit there. It's so important. People, especially academics and educators and policy wonks, should really go read their own blueprint and understand they're part of the systematic destruction of the mind.
Well, it's at AmericanDeception.com, and it's you can type in Dodd, Norman Dodd, or investigation. And the other important document that isn't as long is the one that the conclusions and recommendations for the social studies, 1934. I call that the smoking gun. That is, I talked about it earlier. People get bored with me. That's Carnegie's plan to use the schools to change America's capitalist economic system, and they even talk about taking our land. And Carnegie, from that time on, 1934, every 5 years gave money to Education Commission of the States, the National Assessment. Okay, Common Core people, National Assessment, that's it, that's what you're dealing with. Now, the Education Commission of the States the agreements with the Soviet Union, with the Carnegie's agreement with the Soviet Academy of Science to develop computer courseware in critical thinking, which is Marxist thinking.
By the way, I've seen the Calhoun Reader put out, it was about a decade ago, the University of Texas was using for social workers. We showed it on air. And it was Bob Dacey actually brought it to me, because I'm going from memory. One of his sons was going to school to be a police officer, which he is now, state police. And he had to read this. And it said, we're going to get rid of the family. It belongs to an arcane age. I'm quoting that. I mean, this is the type of crazy stuff. They openly say we're getting rid of the family. It's bad.
Well, nobody believes it. And I have to point out, there is no way for the American people to turn this thing around unless they have the history. Now, I did the history for them in the deliberate dumbing down. And it's there. It's free as a download. That's good. They can get the hard copy at your site and at Amazon. But the most important one we've done, why would I go to the trouble of the last 2 years putting this together, is exposing the global road to ruin through education. It is definitely because it gives Americans a toolkit to go out, show these tapes to your neighbors, to ministers, to businessmen especially, who have no idea they're going to be going out of business if they don't take money from the government, right? To educate school teachers, public school teachers, forget it. They're all gone. Everybody sort of knows that we're going to have Teach for America, these brainwashed college kids coming in to monitor on the computer. Okay, no, but go, please, I plead with you. This is the last product that you'll get out of me. I tried so hard with how many different publications and everything to get this word out. The American, you know, it's good that deliberate dumbing down is a free download. That's great. You could go there, cut, paste, send stuff
out. No, but Charlotte, you have fought so hard. You don't need to do this for the money. You know, your successful business in your life and your late husband, everything you've done, you've fought for, it's got to be 50 years for education, and you've done so much. And if it wasn't for people like you, they would have already won. And exactly, we're not saying public education and Common Core are good. They've already wrecked that. Now they're taking over all the other. We need true local schools, true local private, true local public. We need true local homeschooling. And I've seen it. You cannot find homeschooling groups. You cannot find homeschooling academies. You cannot find any private schools or churches. We go to mega churches. We go to small churches. They're all preaching government doctrine. I talk to the preachers. They admit they're basically government stooges. I mean, this is so deep. It's so bad.
Alex, look, let me point out, our recommendation is to restructure, rebuild the public school system, because it is less lethal than what we're looking at on the other side. The other side is the end of freedom for America.
All right. Well, we're going to have you back on to research this more. Thank you so much. Phone calls, folks, are coming up for two segments. Then another guest on the Black Genocide Agenda. Because they wreck everything. And they get control of everything. And now these foundations are going to get all the property taxes, which is what they've always wanted to do. They socialize it and wreck it. Then they corporatize it and make it fascist after. That's how the globalists operate. They create socialism, then communism. Things collapse, and they come in and reorganize under corporatism that's not really free market. And that's what they're doing. But as for me, my children are 100% homeschooled, and they're just done with the system. Because it doesn't matter where you go, folks, the culture is falling to evil. The culture is falling to tyranny. And I support what Ron Paul's doing, the move towards true homeschooling. And who cares if it's homeschools want to be accredited. So they all go and do an accredited program, which puts you under government control and surveillance, to go to a college where you're never going to get a job in the future. A whole new world's coming of nanotech robots. Knowing how the world really works is going to be the value in the future. Knowing how to skin a buck, run a trot line, grow a garden, be in the underground economy, to know how to live outside the system, but in it as much as you can. Outside the system, but still in it. Of the system, but not part of it. You understand, living in both worlds. I mean, it's going to be a wild time coming. I mean, I've just got to get an herb garden going and learn how to produce my own herbs and, you know, you name it, and stockpile stuff. They're going to ban most of the supplements in the next few years. I mean, it's just getting crazy. I said I'd go to your calls. I appreciate you holding. Gene in Florida, about the mystery illness killing so many people. Go ahead.
Hey, how you doing today? I'm sorry to hear about your uncle, man.
Oh, well, he was a great man, lived a great life, and a great example of the sweetest, most Christian man I ever knew. Wasn't a Bible thumper, but was a deeply Christian man.
Well, good. That's always a good thing, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Have you heard of the term AUAG? I know you have.
I have. Refresh my memory.
Okay. It was at the Denver airport. It was underneath one of the murals, and it was in a mining cart.
Oh,
it was on the floor.
So you're talking about all the cryptic stuff that's all over the Denver airport showing?
Yes, and I'm leading into to these illnesses that we have. If you put in the computer AUAG and you do a search on it, that brings you to the Australian antigen. Have you heard of that?
Yes, tell folks about it.
Okay. Well, unfortunately, if you go a little deeper, this AUAG symbol, or what they're saying, really is not about the Australian antigen. You're talking about nanoparticles and nanos. Have you heard of these things called nanocages?
Yes, I have, and that's what I'm saying. They have biological nanotech now. They have other forms of nanotech where they can just literally have a drone fly over, sprinkle it over, it grows, and the doctors then say there's something there, but we can't tell what it is. It's basically tied to Morgellons. And it's just, God help us, is all I can say. They're totally, look at all the criminal, lethal experiments they've done on us before. And it's still all going on under U.S. Code Title 50, Chapter 32. They can kill you for, quote, any research or law enforcement purpose. I don't care they have it on paper, it still doesn't make it legal. That's how evil this government is.
It goes even deeper and more evil than that. These nanocages, they go into our bodies. And all they have to do, Alex, is take a certain wave or a light beam of some sort, an ultraviolet, and they can shine it on us, and it activates these nanocages.
No, I know. Yeah, no, they can activate them. It's a time bomb. They put them in you, and they activate them. No, in fact, we just put them on screen, yes. No, listen. They injected black people with syphilis, folks. Come on. Frustrated patients are walking out of hospitals without treatment nationwide. Doctor's office spends 2 hours on hold with insurer for surgery authorization before giving up. Not allowed to get surgery unless Obamacare says so. That's all coming up. Let's go to Wesley in Tennessee. You're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Hey, Alex.
Hey, buddy.
I can usually deal with all this police state and zombified unthinking population and the massive, you know, chemical and spiritual attack going on, because, you know, I'm awake and I can largely take care of myself, you know, and I can control what goes into my body.
But it's the targeting of small children by the brainwashing that's totally criminal.
Right. You know, I can control what I subject myself to, but when I hear people, like, I guess it was 2 days ago when Shauna, that last caller, called in, and, you know, her daughter comes on the phone and talks about them trying to take her daughter away, and that obviously that little girl was intelligent, or else they would have easily manipulated that situation. But, you know, and people like in Fukushima, you know, all these people who have no chance of what's going on, they have, you know, hearing stuff like that is what really tears at my heart, you know, and that's the stuff I can't really deal with.
No, and exactly, and I was telling that story, you know, the day after that happened. I mean, they're teaching pedophilia in the schools now. They've legalized it in Italy to literally have people kidnap your kids. If you fight back, you're a pedophobe, a pedophobe, I don't know what you call it, a pervert phobe, a scumbag phobe, a child molester phobe. And if you're a child molester phobe, you're going to jail. And it's like, they're not just going to take our guns. They're taking everything, and they're coming for us.
And it's this political correctness. You can't say anything without being crucified. Or, you know, he'll accountable for something that they can twist any context, any words
well,
you say.
Well, the answer is stop letting them have the moral authority and say you're a bunch of perverts, sicko, filth. It's a badge of honor when you attack us. And that's what's beginning to happen. We can beat these people. People have just become such spectators that we just bow to authority. Well, when the authority is evil, it is absolute imperative to resist it. Resistance to tyrants is obedience to God.
I agree. I don't back down to this stuff. When I hear people try and single me out, well, you don't like Chinese, you don't like Japanese. No, I love Japanese. I love Chinese people. I love humanity.
Listen,
I love
they only do that to get you off kilter because you'll be talking about don't take my guns, and they go, why do you not like black people? Or you'll be talking about let's not have abortion, and they say, why are you racist? Or I don't like Obamacare. Well, why? It's all they know. These are really dumb people that think they're like political geniuses who just know how to call you a name. And then they'll smile like they're a political scientist because they did that. We need to stop bowing to these people. We need to get politically aggressive. I appreciate your call. Great points. Chuck in Texas, go ahead.
Hey, Alex, thank you for taking my call. My condolences to your family.
Thank you, buddy.
A couple of things I'd like to talk about. First is I'd like everybody to make the connection of Eric Holder getting on national TV and saying we need to brainwash everybody into a different way of thinking about guns. And then you see the level of fear being injected into our schools when a child points his finger and goes, pow.
No, that's brainwashing. The federal government is brainwashing our children.
It's absolutely a direct result of the fascist ideology being forced down the throat of American people. It's an act of war against the American people.
It is. No, we're under war. I mean, that's not rhetoric. These people are actual technocratic control freak agents of evil. People ask what army they serve. Folks, they literally are actually servants of Satan. I mean, I've studied them. These people are devil worshipers.
They have a refusal to administer the laws for this country. And it's just ridiculous. I'd like to also say that I was in the hospital about a month and a half ago. And I sat in there for 2.5 hours. And I have insurance, by the way. I sat in there. This is no joke. This is what happened.
No, stay there. We got our guest coming up. I'm going to let you tell your story real quick because I interrupted. Then we'll go to Reverend Childress. Folks, when you have insurance, they run it. They check it. They decide how much they're going to scam you at most hospitals. But if you're an illegal alien or homeless, you go to the head of the line. That's the way it's been for 15 years. We'll be right back. I'm Alex Jones, Infowars.com. Monday through Friday from 11 a.m. to 2 p.m. Central Standard Time, we're here live. And I'll be back this Sunday with a Sunday transmission, 4 to 6 p.m. Central Standard Time. I doubt they'll bury my uncle on Sunday. He died 3:30 a.m. this morning, my beloved Patreon uncle. But if they do end up having a ceremony or something Sunday, I won't be here for the 4 to 6 p.m. show. It'll be David Knight. We don't do a lot of rebroadcasts now. When I've had to go out of town, David Knight does a great job. It's good to have the breaking news and information. We're going to continue with your phone calls later in the hour, but Chuck in Texas was going to finish a brief story on when he went in under the new government-run, corporate-run fraud care and what happened to him, because it's all over the news that people wait 2+ hours for the insurance to authorize emergency surgery, and so it's just denied. Frustrated patients walking out of hospitals across the nation. That's just some of the news breaking on that front. So very, 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 very disgusting what's happening. Also, there are strange glitches causing charges, double mortgage payments in customers' accounts. I mean, it's just going to get crazier. Obamacare has been grabbing money out of people's accounts. I mean, they're coming. This is just legalized total fraud. And so we're going to go to Reverend Childress, an expert on black genocide going on in this country. I wanted to get him on to look at that in perspective with Obamacare and the funding of abortion and more. And also the demonization of the Romneys, you know, making a joke about them having a black baby. I guess they'd rather the baby be aborted. But this just shows just the cynicalness of people like Perry on MSNBC who say the state runs and controls your children. So we're going to talk to Reverend Childress here in just a moment. First off, Chuck, tell your Obamacare story.
Yes, sir. I just wanted to say that I went to the emergency room under emergency conditions, under emergency situation. I sat there for 2.5 hours, and finally I told my wife, let's go. If I pass out or something, maybe they'll see me if I'm unconscious. But I went home, and then they started trying to send me a bill to this doctor that I never saw. So I had to threaten to sue these people to make them quit sending me a bill for a doctor that I never saw. So this whole bozo care thing is a fraud. It's all fraud. And, you know, I don't know what it's going to take to stop it, but it's clear that they're going to make war against God's people, and that's exactly what they're setting out to do.
Well, my father managed partly 200-plus dental clinics, fully 12, well, 24 when he retired this year, early, because he's only 63, because he didn't want to mess with Obamacare. He said it made everybody criminal if you didn't dot an I or cross a T in a computer program. And he said it was, and he testified at the legislature in Texas, by the way, he said it was written to bankrupt the small clinics and regional groups that supply the care. And most of them are all getting out of it, just because it is designed to not deliver care. And they told them, him and others, but other doctors he interviewed at the state level, because that's who by law has to manage these you know, clinics as a doctor. That's kind of a good law, so it's then not some, you know, corporate group doing it with all the things they've been caught doing. And they told him, basically, you work with Obama, you work with the Democrats, you play ball with us, we'll leave you alone. And that's how they always operate. It's kind of like with General Motors 5 years ago in the bailout when it started. They would give you someone's Chevrolet or GMC or other dealership under the GM bailout if you were a Democratic donor in the car business. And they would take it away if you were a Republican. And they got away with it. So why not triple your rates? Why not take kids that are 10 years old, 11 years old, and give them abortions without parental consent? Why not give inoculations without parental consent nationwide, even though it's illegal? The government is involved in a mass criminal orgy to set the precedent and take over. I appreciate your call, sir. Yeah, this is the new way that they do things. Anybody who's a client of the system until it collapses, illegal aliens, you name it, they'll get first-rate care immediately. If you've got perfect insurance, like happened to my buddy, who's very wealthy this last weekend with his young daughter, took her to the hospital because she had a fever and sinus deal. I would have gone to a clinic, but a lot of those were packed or closed. And he shot video. He sent it to me on my phone. I think he may authorize me to put it out later. And it was all these illegals just going right through, just like God. And I've had it happen to me. But the citizens, black, white, Hispanic, with insurance, they had to wait. And there was only a few people that were citizens in there. And if you had ID and stuff, you were scum. You're penalized when you have insurance. You're penalized when you pay taxes. You're marked as a schmuck, as an idiot, as a target, as a moron. Okay, that's what this is. The globalists are above the law. The illegals are above the law. We're the only people. Black, white, Hispanic, Asian, I don't care. You play in the system, you're fair, you're good, they use you. And we're the enemy once things collapse as well. Now, Pastor Clenard Howard Childress is a prominent preacher. He has the powerful website, blackgenocide.org. And he's, of course, written several books, one of them, No Shepherd's Cry. And he also has been in films and documentaries and CBN exposing that 52% of blacks never make it out of the womb. And I've had him on before because when I've been at debates or at interviews or out in public and I run into Democratic operatives who will come over mainly black and say, oh, it's Alex Jones, the racist. I look at him and I say, you know, I'm somebody who's a libertarian constitutional Christian who wants to bring people together. I'm a classical liberal in the Thomas Jefferson vein. And I care about the content of how you act and what you stand for. If you're an incredible mind, an incredible musician, a neat person, I want to hang out with you regardless of what color you are. And I said, you know, how dare you talk like that? Oh, yeah, whatever. And I go, hey, you're the folks that push abortion. Are you against aborting all these black babies? No, there are too many black people, too many weeds. And since then, you've seen abortion doctors and people, one of them Asian, saying, nobody wants these ugly black babies. I have had black people working at Access TV for over a decade constantly get in my face, Democratic operatives, and say, I'm sick of your anti-abortion, Jones. Who's going to adopt these black babies? Nappy-headed, blah, blah, blah. I mean, that's like a thing they would say. And now you've seen videos of blacks saying that online and Planned Parenthood saying that. But it's like a thing they say. And I would always be freaked out by it. I'm racist because I'm white because I don't want to chop up black babies. And back then, I would have a lot of anti-abortion people on the local show. We'd go out and protest the Planned Parenthood in East Austin, mainly blacks going in. And because I didn't want black women to murder their children, I'm racist. Now, you got to remember that, folks. I don't like Obamacare. I'm racist. And I know I've talked to Childress before. We've interviewed him for films and things. He says he's heard and seen that same thing. And then you see the disdain and the hatred that the Romneys would adopt a black baby instead of it being chopped up by MSNBC. Sir, I want you to talk about the black genocide agenda and where it's going under Obamacare and the globalists. But I'm going from memory that you say you've heard those same type of stories. Can you relay that attitude or is my memory wrong that when I've had you on and talked about that, you've heard that exact same statement?
Oh, habitually. For an African-American preacher to make those comments and draw attention to the disproportionate amount of African-Americans who are systemically being targeted. Even when we come up with the facts, we're Uncle Toms, We're being used by the system. We're flunkies. We surrendered our devotion to African Americans. It's very befuddling and confusing when we stand attempting to point to the simple fact, and it's very easily proven, that African Americans are being targeted by the abortion industry and the platform that they use to seduce African Americans is clearly the Democratic Party. And some of the biggest sellouts are in the Democratic Party. There's no question about it. And I believe they're basically embarrassed by it, that they could be bamboozled in such a way. But the evidence is very clear. 1,786 African-American children are killed each day by abortion. 52% of all African-American pregnancies end in abortion. We make up roughly 12.4% of the population and 36% of the abortions. Now,
oh, so it's up from 52%.
Oh, it's 52% of all African-American pregnancies end in abortion.
Yes.
That's the last data. But I was saying, basically one-third of all abortions are African-Americans. Yeah. Now, to my pain, but I should not have been surprised, I can say to your audience, I have complete evidence that the Congressional Black Caucus knows those statistics. And upon learning of them, they actually caucus together to come up with talking points, how to refute people like myself and the growing, swelling grassroots movement of people beginning to question their politicians on these facts.
And by the way, what you're talking about is they were shown MAFA 21, and it turned out they knew the truth. And tell people about that.
And more or less, they were more concerned, as most narcissistic politicians are, about their own power, about getting reelected, and not offending the Democratic Party. You got to understand, the line has been drawn in the sand here with Obamacare. We knew it from the Democratic convention when it was exposed. They tried to take God out and basically out of the platform, and African Americans didn't move. If anyone should have moved, it should have been African Americans. But the fact of the matter is, what he promised Planned Parenthood, Barack Obama, in the Freedom of Choice Act, he hid it inside of Obamacare. He is saying to every conscious American, we control your conscience. We will tell you what to pay for. You will buy this, and it will support the killing of a baby, and you have to like it. Lines drawn in the sand, okay? And this nation is heading towards a major confrontation. It's going to be of Civil War proportion.
I agree. Stay there. Exactly. Exactly. A race war, because that's all they can pull. Now, meanwhile, 50 plus million babies have been killed. This is so evil. And instead of us having a civil war against the tyrants, they want to make it a black-white civil war. Let's go back to Reverend Childress in this short segment. We'll break down some of the history of the black genocide on the other side. But the genocide of people in this country, those that are least advantaged, is a beta test in all the documents we covered last hour for everybody. The secret testing, all of it, it's being done to everybody. And Planned Parenthood and the Democratic Modern Party, I'm not even a Republican, folks, were set up to kill black people. I've got all the letters, all the documents, Margaret Sanger. And it's just what makes me sick about MSNBC and Harris Perry and all of them is they're just monsters, folks. And I've been around Democrats behind the scenes for years. And they are the nastiest group. They'll look at you, black, white, I don't care, particularly black. They go, there's not enough money. We need to get rid of these black people and say bad names about them. And my thing is that these idiots believe Bill Gates when he says kill a granny. Kill granny. Get rid of granny. And then you can have 10 teachers' jobs. It's this idea that we kill people and get stuff. Folks, Japan's going to collapse. Italy's going to collapse. They have 1.2, 1.3 kids for every two adults. You need 2.1 replacement rate to even hold civilization up. And the globalists know this. And it makes me upset. Reverend Childress, I'm ranting. Keep making your points. Where you were going with this clash, where they're going to make Christians pay for abortions, violating the First Amendment. I mean, it's just never going to end. Go ahead.
This is the most imposing and egregious legislation ever passed in this nation's history. And it was Albert Einstein who said, never surrender conscience, even if the state demands it. Well, he grew up in Germany. He knew what he was talking about. The state is demanding your conscience right now, America. The state is saying, we are your conscience, and we make your decisions. There's no such thing. We determine right and wrong. This is a serious time in this country, and we need to wake up. Now, you mentioned the reporter from MSNBC that made the comment about the Romney child. You have to understand how this is all going down, what their means of seduction is. They have to lay claim to the civil rights movement. They have to say they're the benevolent ones. They're the ones that are caring for the African-American. And they use it as a means to embarrass whites and to control white America by then calling them racist if you don't agree with them. So here's a perfect example of what I'm talking about. It was proven this past week. Phil Robinson, God bless him, Duck Dynasty, stood up for his conviction, stood up and said homosexuality is basically wrong. Same-sex marriage is wrong. It was a GQ magazine interview. Mainstream media said, here's our chance to exert our power. We're going to get them to back down. Here's Jesse Jackson. You got to meet with me in 72 hours or we're going to insinuate we're going to boycott you. Thank God A&E told them to go take a hike. But yet also, thank God, money does speak. The family stuck together, so he's right back where he's supposed to be. Why am I even mentioning this? In the same week, I repeat, the same week, Louis Farrakhan, the main potentate, the main leader for the Muslim movement in this country, went to the pulpit in Chicago and said, homosexuals should be beheaded. Why wasn't there any media about that? Is because they didn't want to bring attention to a prominent black male speaking against same-sex marriage that they had no answer to, because this is not the scenario they're trying to project.
Well, especially, they only want to demonize Christians, too.
Right. And so here it is. Right, exactly. Anything to do with Christ, Christian, they will attack, they will abuse, they will.
I want to ask you why that is, Reverend, on the other side, then get into some of the history of black genocide that you're an expert on. We'll be right back with our guests. And this stuff really shakes me up, folks, because it's so bizarro world where you're racist if you don't want to kill black babies. And then black people, liberal black people, get in your face like they want to get in a fight with you if you don't want to kill black people. I'm not kidding. I mean, it's crazy.
We're on the march. The empire's on the
last 25, 30 minutes of the worldwide transmission today. I'm your host, Alex Jones. Reverend Childress is our guest. BlackGenocide.org, Pastor Clenard Howard Childress is our guest. And if you look at it, they only assault Christianity. They try to take it over. They try to megachurch it. They try to Romans 13 it. They try to infraguard it, clergy response team it, faith-based initiative it, totally take it over, World Council of Churches, ecumenical, all of it. And now they've got it down to the point where they're going to make Catholic churches, Protestant churches, you name it, pay for abortion coverage. And they've got a tax in Travis County, only county in Texas where taxpayers pay an abortion fee. So that's the type of stuff that's going on, and it's about forcing you to do what they want. Look at Italy, just said a 60-year-old man can grab an 11-year-old out of the back of a yard and rape him, and the social workers say it's love. That's the actual AFP headline. They can teach five-year-olds how to have bestiality, you name it, in public schools. And again, it's called being politically correct. No, it's called evil taking over. And it's called assaulting everything that's good. And at the bottom of the rabbit hole, I've learned, is really evil people. And I'm not here judging people that have good hearts and don't consciously try to go out and do bad stuff. But these globalists get off on the bad, and they want to pull down all that's good. And there's a war on Christianity. So, Reverend Childress, talk about that and why they're persecuting the Christians and where you think this is going, and why do you think they're accelerating their program with the same woman that made fun of Mitt Romney's grandchild being black in a white family, and said, you know, there's nothing that, you know, these people are all different, you know, and is this racist or whatever, dividing people, and is the same one that says the state controls your kids. I mean, they're really out in the open pushing the whole agenda.
You know, unfortunately, and it's a deep unfortunately, that it's still, you know, politics is perception. And we still, this America still feels that the Democratic Party were the facilitators of civil rights. And so these things that they're doing is actually to help people and to be upward and mobile. And they could be nothing further than the truth. And you mentioned this case in England. I didn't hear of it before, and I'm thank God I am hearing, because I just had the discussion that the clergy do not realize that pedophilia is next. They're gaining this ground through the judicial tyranny on same-sex marriage. Pretty soon, everything, if you can change the definition of marriage, you can change it. And of course, you did it with the sanctity of life, the definition of what life is. You can now indeed communicate that what that man did to that 11-year-old girl is love. And our society, Christian, if you're a Christian, the line is drawn now. If we fold on this, we're done. We are done. And so I didn't ever want it to come to this. I never thought I'd live in America that there would be a day of time like this. But it has come, and there must be a clear message sent to this administration. We will not comply. Plain and simple, we will not comply. And whatever that means, we have to then just, you know, take the hit. We are Americans. This is not, this is un-American. It's unconstitutional. I don't know what is in Congress these days, but this certainly now we the people must galvanize. We the people. It has to be just like Duck Dynasty. If Pop don't go on, we all don't go on. That's the way it has to be right now. And so they have gained this mindset that I believe only good people. You mentioned what's at the bottom of the barrel. Once again, Edmund Burke, all evil has to do is the triumph is for good people to say nothing and be silent. All the good people now, we have to take it up another level, another notch. We have to be vocal. This, the line is drawn, proceed no further. I believe Notre Dame today has to comply, according to the judge, to Obamacare. They have to provide these contraceptives. I wouldn't do it. I wouldn't do it. Just don't do it. You can't do it at this point.
Well, look at how they're openly trying to tell churches what they can and can't do. That's totally the Soviet Union. I mean, there's no doubt that this is illegal.
It's socialism, it's communism, whatever you want to call it. It's a takeover. I said from the beginning, and thank God for people like Ben Carson who are still echoing, this was never about health care. Never about health care. It was about control from day one. It's about control. It's about intrusion. It's about being able to sort out who our enemies are of the present administration. I mean, this is undoubtedly we're at the threshold here, and there's only one people, those good people you talked about, those good Americans. We cannot allow this. You just can't comply. We must now turn this around in such fashion, peaceably, I believe, is the way to do it. I am a student of Dr. King, but there's no doubt you cannot comply to this. Your rights are being taken away. Your freedoms are being taken away. And worst of all, conscience. You cannot allow government to dictate to you your conscience. And whether they like it or not, this is a Judeo-Christian country, Judeo-Christian, built on those Christian principles. That is under attack. That is being stripped. That is what really is at the core of all of this. But that's what the mindset of which birthed this country. Flawed, yes, but always remember, those flaws were dealt with through the Constitution and through the spirit of the Constitution.
That's right. That's right. The Bill of Rights was awesome. Sure, yeah. It wasn't realized and still hasn't been fully realized. But yeah, we know what's coming in is classical tyranny, not classical liberty. But I mean, it is a spirit of the world, though. It really does come down to this, that they're after real Christians. They're after homeschoolers. They're openly saying they're going to outlaw that in Ohio and places. I mean, they're coming. We've got to get on the offense now because they're not going to back down.
Offense, offense, offense. We waited too long as it is. It shouldn't have got to this point. And that's why I'm doing a march in October. I will be at rallies. I'll be at the Walk for Life San Francisco. I'm going to tell you right now, that is going to be a highly charged political speech I give. And there's no doubt, I know they listen to my phone. I'm sure they know my website. The Congressional Black Caucus even mentioned me by name. I was very proud of that. But the fact of the matter is, if we do not stand up now, the America as we know it will be long gone. And I would not want to believe, as some people would say, this law cannot be repealed. Any law can be repealed.
That's all psych warfare when the Republican leadership won't get rid of it. And, oh, it can't. And, oh, it's a giant social takeover, social engineering, death panels. The big banks are behind it because they want all the extra money. I mean, this is the end of this country. And people are saying, oh, we can't repeal it when it's completely unpopular across the board. It's all mind games. We have crooks in Washington. They have a 6% approval rating in Congress. They need to be arrested. This is a criminal conspiracy. And if they can kill 53 million babies, of course they can do secret testing on people. And of course they can radiate foster children and shoot people up with syphilis. And of course they can teach pedophilia in schools, because we've let the crazy people that crave the power take over every level of society.
You know, everybody my age, that you may feel your time, you know, to retire or to lay back. No, we know the way. We know what the heart and the vision of the great visionaries of this country had for this country. And you're right. You know, I do a piece. We hold these truths to be self-evident. The nation never really held that truth. But one day, I believe Dr. King said we would hold that truth. I believe right now this is a defining hour where truly, you know, I don't want to use the term take our country back or that, but basically getting back to the heart of the Constitution, to the heart of the Declaration of Independence. In it is the most powerful political document ever conceived. We have to get back there, demand there. It is still we the people. It's not perfect, but what is coming down the pike now is criminal. It is not freedom. It certainly isn't the vision of the Founding Fathers. And we have to be more vocal. We have to go to PTA. Boards. We have to go to our local town meetings and council meetings. We certainly have to go to the legislature. We have to use the intimidation of we the people. There's more of us than them. Case closed. We have to use that. And all of us have to step up. We're losing. I will not turn willfully to my grandchildren a nation of this caliber. It would be criminal upon me not to do everything. That
sure. Well, I mean, Reverend, also look how historically, once things get to this point, things collapse. It's not just going to keep rotting for a long time now. All of the liberty and all the blessings are leaving. The curses are coming. We're being overrun. All our basic freedoms are going away. The prosperity is going away. I mean, we know the wages of this collectivist new world order are death. We know the fruits of this system are not good.
And people like yourself unquestionably have to keep sounding that message. We can't assume people recognize that this is it. 2014, probably the most important year of our nation's history due to the climate and where we're at right now. It has never been this bad. And if there isn't a turnaround in 2014, I don't see us recovering, because it would mean that we capitulated and allowed this to go on without a significant upheaval, and certainly letting our voices be heard in November. This is extremely pivotal year. Anyone who believes in righteousness and the goodness of the country, the Constitution, the Declaration of Independence, I mean, anyone who holds those things dear, you have to ask, what level do I take this to now? And whatever we've been doing is not good enough. I'm talking about myself, too. Whatever I've done, obviously, is not good enough. It's got to go to another level. This is war. And if indeed we are to survive, it's going to take those good people you mentioned earlier to know that good will triumph if good speaks up. If good is willing to sacrifice and go to the front line, good will prevail. God is still on the throne, but he's waiting for the good people to step forward.
What's going to happen if we don't turn the country around?
I don't even want to think about that. I'm going to be honest with you. I've never thought, as I stated earlier, that I would never live in a country where there is no, I mean, how can you have an administration that just totally ignores the Constitution and the Declaration of Independence with impunity? I mean, who is challenging this onslaught against the rights of its citizens? And so the citizens at this point have to rise up. I can look at throughout history and see where this has happened in other countries. Once again, never thinking it could happen here. But I better be taking better notes on what I used to see in other nations, because it is here. And if we do not rise up, and it's not going to be whether you're white or black, it's going to be whether you believe in righteousness. Do you believe that marriage is between one man, one woman? Do you believe that that is a baby, the sanctity of life? Those are the things that are going to galvanize. Do you believe you have the right to believe as you choose to believe and to worship as you choose to worship? Do you have those rights? And for what I know of the history, that Christianity ought to trump all those. Why should I be in a nation that was founded by those principles and watch them dismantle those principles and every emblem or sign of those principles without saying something? This is absurd.
And then have the public schools, for those that don't know, all over the country teach very small children, kindergarten, first, second, third grade, stuff that I didn't even know about until I was 20 years old. And that's in this corrupt, decadent world. And teaching kids they could be a boy, girl, or both, and you can have your own bathroom. I mean, that is pedophilia. That is setting the precedent that the state is going to do what they want with your kids, and they've said that. Why do you think they're moving so fast right now? Because I do see a backlash. Do you think they're moving fast because they see us gaining ground? Or why do you think they're coming out of the sicko closet with the pedophilia and the state owns your kids and we're going to take your 11-year-old to have an abortion even if you don't want it? I mean, why are they doing this, Reverend?
It's shockingly. So I have to believe it's evil's deadline, that I can't see humans being that galvanized and that strategic. It's almost like it is pure evil, as if it knows something that we don't, and that we must get this nation to succumb. If this nation succumbs, they basically have the world. If the Christians in America fold, they will fold. They in their mindset, it will fold globally. So we have to understand we are at that point. We're at the crossroads. Once again, you're mentioning so many fronts, the schools. Most of your listeners, I don't believe, know that they are already conditioning your children for pedophilia. There's going to be a lack of identity crisis in the African-American community. Can you imagine how painful and how hurtful that's going to be when there's already 70% of the homes do not have the very element that God started with first, man in the house? And you think they're not going to have a problem with identity? You think they're not going to have a problem with their sexuality? Absolutely. And the public school system feels this is the America that we are creating now. It's too demonic. There's no way in the world this could be a person. This is a group of people whom we probably don't ever see. No doubt. And I honestly believe the rollout was a message from God to us. This is what you're agreeing to. I believe that the NSA and the IRS and all this being exposed, thank God for Snowden, that is being exposed, that is saying, We are coming into a police state where we will not have any say so, and certainly they're not going to want to hear about our religion. Remember, religion is the opiate of the people. This is the man's face who has chosen to bring this new world.
Well said. Stay there, Reverend. We're going to come right back. By the way, because of Fukushima getting unstable again and the fuel rod removal and that radioactive wave coming towards the United States, obviously the federal government has ordered 14 million dosages of the medical type iodine that protects the thyroid from radiation. But that's for the federal workers. We called them yesterday, the videos up on Infowars.com, and they hung up when we brought up Fukushima. It's very incriminating, very scary. Here's some of the other headlines. Iran says Saudi intelligence ordered embassy bombing in Lebanon. Yeah, they also ordered the bombing of the Russians. Scientists look for evidence of time travelers on the internet. That's not our kind of story usually, but they're actually doing it. Crazed hypocrite Congressman King calls Snowden terrorist appeaser when our own government runs al-Qaeda. Labels New York Times an accomplice. Did North Korea Kim Jong-un feed his uncle to the starving dogs? That's the craziness of authoritarianism. Government official hangs up when asked about iodine purchases. There's that article by Paul Joseph Watson. Infographic on Infowars.com. How to handle a police encounter. Now Disney can track your every move with NSA-style wristbands. That's just some of the stories up on Infowars.com and Prisonplanet.com. And we are, I'm sorry to the other callers, I'm out of time. I got to deal with some stuff with family after the show. Or I'd go into overdrive and take your calls, but I'll be back Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m. We're going to get a final word from Reverend Childress here in a moment. But folks, here's the deal. I, in my gut, feel empathy when I know they're targeting black people to kill 52% of them. And then it makes me mad when they weaponize the black culture through MTV to make it anti-white, everything else, and to push the whole agenda. I mean, it's just like incredible. It's like you're trying to save people, you're trying to save yourself, and then they're taught to hate you. And then that makes white people think the blacks are all out to get them, and that creates the hate on the other side, which is divide and conquer. And just to watch these evil people, especially on MSNBC, knowingly punching buttons, following playbooks, makes me very, very angry. And I'm beyond anger because I want a civilization, I want a future. And let me tell you something, folks, if they can target black people with all these secret tests and aborting them, they can do it to anybody. And that's why I have empathy. Empathy is because in your gut, in your spirit, you know what's happening to somebody else is happening to you because you're connected to them. And it's going to end up happening to your family. And so we better all come together against the New World Order and realize Barack Obama is the more effective of evils. He's carrying the ball for the New World Order. It's not that the Republican leadership's good either. Notice how they're going after the Tea Party because it's got real people in it that know what's going on. That's why they say it's racist, because they don't want black people or anybody else to feel like they could have the American dream of a Bill of Rights, Constitution, due process. That's what this is about, folks. So I think the answer is white people need to go to the black neighborhoods. Black people need to go to the white neighborhoods. Everybody needs to start coming together for the Bill of Rights and Constitution. People organize themselves in groups. We need to organize ourselves as Christians and people that love justice. Final comments, Reverend Childress.
You said it. That's right. And that's what's going to happen. I believe that we're going to come based on values that we no longer judge anyone by the color of skin, but by the content of character. And that's all we're going to have is the same values. The beauty of the Tea Party is that no one perceived it. It birthed out of disdain for laws that were infringing upon their rights and upon their wealth and prosperity. This has to continue to grow. And unquestionably, that I believe it'll always come from people who have a heart for the things of God. I think it's something that God is waiting for. He did say, if my people, which are called by my name. And so we have to recognize we're at that point. Please don't wait for 2015. We have to do this. There has to be a clear clarion cry this year. This year, this time, this season.
Everyone in their spirit, yes. Everyone in their spirit has got to realize that there's dread in the air. And you're right. We take action, God will move. We've got to walk out on faith. Historically, we will get the providence to turn the tide. God bless you, sir. And people can visit your website, blackgenocide.org. It's invaluable. Thank you so much, Reverend.
Thank you for having me.
God bless you all, folks. See you back this Sunday, 4 to 6 p.m., Nightly News Tonight.
You are listening to GCN.